Thanks for joining me, everyone. Today I've got the ORX and I'm searching the Field of Dreams. So join me in the XP Skill School. As I said in the intro, we're on the Field of Dreams today. Why do we call it the Field of Dreams? Because there's nothing here. All you can do is walk around with a detector and dream about what you might find. So I kind of got you here on false pretenses, really. But anyway, I'm using the ORX, the high frequency coil. I'm just going to run through some settings, have some live digs, and perhaps show you some tweaks on the way. So let's get cracking. People ask, what's the difference between coin deep and coin fast? Well, coin fast is a little bit better behaved if you've got a lot of iron and contamination on your sights, whereas coin deep is quite a raw program, and you'll find the difference just between switching the two. You can hear the audio difference and the way the machine performs. So here we go. Here we're in the standard coin fast with no adjustments, 14.4 kilohertz. And as you can hear, the machine's giving the low tone on some iron, but in general, it's very, very well behaved. That's iron, low tone iron. Iron probability meter's going up there. Now, let's just switch to coin deep and let you hear the difference. We just do the hashtag button once, and there it is, coin deep, still on 14 kilohertz factory presets. And as you can hear, the machine is a little bit more choppy, a little bit more spiky, which is telling me coin deep is probably too powerful for this terrain, whereas coin fast is probably the way to go. Iron. Nice solid bit of iron. The iron probability meter is right at the top. Well, that's better. That's jumping from the high to the mid-tone. And I'm getting about 80 on the meter. 72, 65, it's jumping around quite a bit, actually. Let's have a little dig, see what we got. You may have noticed I've got the MI6 paired to the ORX, so the audio comes directly through the headphones. So when the MI6 is switched on, the coil is switched off. Oh, that's quite a deep one. We'll have to keep going a little bit. Getting closer. It's out. There it is, whatever it is. It's a coin of some sort, I'm sure it's a coin. But again, probably about eight inches down, 9 inches down, something like that. So let's have a listen to the audio now. Perfect. That was quite a deep target. Don't forget, we've got a video out on the XP website showing how to identify deep targets. The link's up here. Yep, we'll go for that, 70 on the meter. Yeah, pretty good, let's have a go at that one. It's out. There we go. Oh, look, it's a button. Move around in a circle. Really starts to get choppy now. Oh, I don't know about that one, but I'm going to have a go at it anyway. Pinpointing with the ORX is exactly the same as the Deus. You just use the drawback method. So give it tiny little wiggles, bring the coil back, and when the target disappears, it's exactly under that red XP logo on the front of the coil. This is a bit of a suspicious one. It's quite choppy, but it has got a spike with it, and it's always worth investigating some of these targets because you just never know. No sign of it at all now. Let's have a look with a probe. Completely disappeared. Maybe it's such a small target, it's actually out in the spoil. Let's stamp the spoil down a little bit. There it was in the spoil, look. Trying to escape me. Well, that's what it is. I think that is a part of a buckle, but it's got some really nice decoration on it. I don't know if you can see that on camera, but interesting. Yeah, nearly got away from me, that one. Fantastic. It's always good to find these interesting little bits. Yeah, look at that, loads of decoration on it. Right, let's crack on and see if we can find something else. Now, this is a little bit different. Can you hear the audio is slightly quieter? It's still solid. Still needs a bit of investigation. But the signal sounds a little bit shorter. Tidying it up a little bit. Nothing on the pinpointer yet, so I think that's got to be a little bit deeper, perhaps. Come on. Still nothing on the pinpointer. Oh, wait a minute. Look at that. Just a little rumble at the bottom. I'll keep quiet. Can you hear that? Here we go then. Out. No. This is a strange one. It's out. Look at that. Guess what? It's round. Look how deep that was. It's a button. But do you know what? That deep, that's really impressive. Try and picture that signal again in your mind. It was choppy, it was very short. It had a little bit of contamination with it as well. Understandable if it's 9-10 inches down, isn't it? I'll just let you look in the hole just to show you how deep it was. We started getting the pinpoint rumble about that sort of depth, so I took some more out. So that button was that deep with the ORX. Pretty impressive, I'd say. What do you think, iron? Not so bad this way. I think I must have disturbed it, so it's somewhere down there, I'm guessing. Solid 51 on the meter now. Oh, look at that! Look at that! That's a nibbled hammered coin. Well, I never. It's very clean as well. I'm just going to check the hole just to see if there's anything else in there. No, I think that's all there is. Let's just whiz the probe in there. Nope. That's it. So what do you think of that? Little beauty, hammered coin. Broken on the cross where it goes across. It's a long cross coin. I don't really know what it is apart from that. But cast your mind back to what that sounded like. That was a little bit of a dodgy signal. It was almost iron one way, but when I turned 90 degrees, it cleaned it up a little bit. But again, you don't know what sort of orientation these things are in the ground, so you've got to kind of like second guess the signals, if you like. You've got to be a little bit brave with digging stuff. But one thing I have found out, that this ORX does like the silver. Our favorite sort of signal, guys. Very faint. Listen to that. Love it. I wonder what it is. Go a little bit wider just in case it is deep. Yep, it's a deep one. So faint. Right, last spade full, and then we'll give the MI6 a go. Here we go. Nothing. Oh, this is getting interesting. Okay, let's keep going. Bit deeper now. what came out in that spade for. Wow, look how deep that was. Okay, what is it? Got it here, look. There it is. Well, I can tell you it's a button. That's 100% sure. It's got some markings on it. But look how deep it was. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.